women's free skate as you take one more look at the German champions in the pairs. Back to Le Colisée in just a moment.
To the women's free skate and some surprising occurrences, Tracy, which have cast this thing wide open.
Well, Laura Lepisto of Finland surprised us and surprised herself quite frankly in the short program, 15 points above her personal best to have herself in first place. Now, she's just moved up from juniors. This is her first time at the Senior Grand Prix. First time in the short program she tried the triple-triple combination, and of course she landed it. And you know, we've been checking our record books. We think this is the first Finnish skater to be leading after the short program in a Grand Prix event. So she doesn't quite have the difficulty of some of the other skaters in the field. She'll be hard-pressed to hold on to that lead. But boy, let's hope she keeps this role going. Fun to watch.
Yes, and here's the news for Laura Lepisto of Finland. Maua Sada Japan lurks, and so does the Canadian hope, Joanny Rochette. Also, a great men's competition is developing. The world champion, Brian Joubert, absolutely fabulous in the short program. And with a preview of tomorrow's men's final, here's Brenda Irving along with Kurt Browning.
Heading into the free skate, Brian Joubert, the world champion with an 11-point lead over the rest of the field here at Skate Canada, and barring a major catastrophe for him, he should win this title.
Yeah, unless his blades fall off. I mean, Brian came out as the new world champion, and I can remember
the first time I had to defend my world title. I felt like I was wearing someone else's skates. I flew all the way to Japan. The first time out as a world champion, I hit my head on the ice and fell twice during the short program. I'm really proud of Brian. He did great. Now we've got a competition where between second and sixth, I believe, there's like 1.5 points. This is the kind of a competition you want to watch. And three Canadians in there, no one's going to miss the long program if you're a fan of figure skating.
Jeff Buttle, he's going to try the quad in Sunday's program. Expectations for him?
Well, you know what? Jeff has done something to himself. He set a really high standard, and now it's up to him to keep up to himself. I don't think he's competing against Joubert here or anybody else. It's whether or not he can get back on pace for himself. And I'm putting words in his mouth, but I really think it's important for Jeffrey to get back on the horse, land a good program, get back some momentum, and, you know, and have the world look at him with confidence again.
Well, it should be a great free program. You've got the world champion, Brian Joubert, yep, and three Canadians fighting out for a medal here at Skate Canada. Also tomorrow on Home Sense Skate Canada International on CBC, we're going to be bringing you the Ice Dance free program. Big expectations for Canada's Virtue and Moya. They lead after the compulsories. A win here would be their first ever on the Senior Grand Prix Tour. And as Kurt and I just mentioned, we'll also have the conclusion of the men's skating competition. But right now, we're going to get set for our next competition. That is the women's free skate. But first, we're going to take a look back at some of the big stories making news in the world of women's figure skating this past year. Here are the headlines. The landscape of women's skating shifted dramatically at last year's World Championships, and the new young stars are steamrolling ahead. For the first time in history, all three world medalists are Asian. And for the first time in a decade, all three are teenagers. Another teenager on this side of the ocean is getting a lot of attention. American Caroline Zhang will be making her senior debut. Like world champion Miki Ondo, silver medalist Maua Sada, and bronze medalist Yuna Kim, Zhang is also a junior world champion. And she lived up to all those expectations, finishing third at Skate America last week, her senior debut.
And as for Canada's Joanny Rochette, the question is, how will she rebound after a disappointing season? It was a little more than a year ago when she finished fifth at the Olympics. But last March, in a stunning reversal, she dropped to 10th in the world. Can she find her way back to the top tier of women's figure skaters?
Thank you, Brenda. And there, Tracy, is 19-year-old Cynthia Phaneuf, the former Canadian champion, who was, I suppose, not pleased with her short program, and here in front of the home crowd would want to move up.
She definitely would, but she also wants to add some triple jumps. She was off the ice a couple of years ago due to injuries. She went through a major growth spurt, and lost her jumps, lost her desire to skate, and she's been working her way back. She's very motivated now. She needs to keep adding triple jumps to her repertoire to be competitive with this field.
Let's take a look at the standings after the short program for the women here at Skate Canada International. In a surprise, 19-year-old Laura Lepisto of Finland has the lead. That was her personal best by 15 points, if you can believe it. Emily Hughes of the United States is next. Maua Sada stumbled to be third. Joanny Rochette still in position there in fifth place. The other day, Tracy, and she said, I'm at my best now when I find serenity, when I'm at peace with myself on the ice. But it's been tough to get that.
Skating to a piece of music that should help her to calm her nerves and find that serenity she's looking for, Claire de Lune. This choreographed by her longtime choreographer, David Wilson. She will open with a series of double axels. Very nice. Building now for her first triple, a triple Lutz.
She's gone through from 5'3" to 5'9". And what eludes you, first and foremost, are the jumps. And it's got to be so difficult to get them back.
It is, because everything changes and you have to relearn your technique. She said once she understood, she had to start from the beginning. That helped her a lot. Now, she is planning to attempt 6 triples, hoping to land 4. Triple flip, and she popped it to a single. Now, the triple flip and the loop, she has not been able to land successfully since she was a Canadian champion. And here comes the loop. Let's see if she goes for it. Good effort. Good effort. Very tall for a figure skater, harder to rotate in the air.
Trains in Contrecoeur, not far from Montreal, with Annie Barabé and Sophie Richard.
Double toe, double toe, double loop.
Michelle, her mom, Martin, her boyfriend, Jerome, as well as her training partners, Jessica Dubé and Bryce Davison, are ringside to support their teammate. Thank you.
difficult to be at the top of your game and a Canadian champion, yet a young teenager, than to lose it and work your way back under the spotlight? You have to ask why. Well, for me, it's clear. When I watch Cynthia Phaneuf, it's about the joy of skating. She clearly loves to do what she does.
Her dad, Michelle, her mom, Martin, Cynthia Phaneuf tries to battle back. Her teammate, Leslie Hawker, has ambitions of her own. She's next. You're watching Home Sense Skate Canada International on CBC. Cynthia Phaneuf came into this free skate in 10th position. Here are her marks, technical elements, 42.67. Her presentation score, 42.48. Two deductions, so that's an 83.15.
But a heartfelt performance by Cynthia Phaneuf. She has to continue to work on her strength. She can do the triples in practice. The next step is getting them in the competition.
And her family in the stands, amongst a large group of supporters for Cynthia Phaneuf here at Le Colisée in Quebec. And now she will stand by and watch her teammate, the inspirational Leslie Hawker, take to the ice. Here's a 26-year-old who first made the national team at age 23.
Skating to I'll Be Seeing You and Hymn to the Fallen.
Championships. The way it shakes down for Canadian female skaters right now is there are two spots to the World Championships. She wants to move up to catch one of those and perhaps on to the Olympics in 2010.
was her final plan, triple at triple Sal Cow. It just didn't get the oomph, get the height to rotate it. She's got to now just start pushing through. She does not need to play it safe anymore. She needs to push it out and finish strongly. Her skating between the jumps and the elements has improved tremendously this year. It's a big difference. She's been watching Janet Lynn, American champion in the 70s. Janet, known for her grace and style, and that has rubbed off on Leslie. What a beautiful performance.
And Jamie Doherty has a PhD and studies stem cell biology at the University of Toronto. He'll be watching.
What I love about Leslie is she has just taken such a unique path here. Landed her first triple jump when she was 16 years of age. National team, as you said, when she was 23. Came to it late. She put herself, paid for her skating by waitressing. Anything's possible when you watch Leslie. And unfortunately, that glitch at the end of an otherwise flawless performance. And that was quite an easy jump for Leslie. I shouldn't have done that, Leslie. But she got the flip in, and the triple flip has been a bit of a problem. You know, we kibitz about it because she says, I don't have a problem with the flip. But that would be the one jump that she traditionally would miss in competition. Did it beautifully there, along with two gorgeous triple Lutzes, and the triple Lutz, triple flip, the most difficult triple jumps that Leslie does.
And really serious, Tracy, about this Olympic dream that she has moved not so recently, but within the last little while to Michigan to train and on a full-time basis, and really very focused on getting to those Olympic Games in 2010.
That's her coach, Richard Callahan. He coached Tara Lipinski to her Olympic gold medal.
Yeah, we were talking to her the other day and asked her the very simple question in an interview situation, where have you come from, where you're going? And she said, I'm from a small town, I'm going to the Olympics. So this is a part of the plan at Skate Canada. A step along the way, if she is to get there, she's got to compete against, obviously, Joanie Richet, Cynthia Phaneuf, Merrily Young, who we saw have a good performance at Skate America last week. All right, so the marks for Leslie Hawker. Technical elements, 46-67, 43-92. On presentation, and that will be enough to give her the lead, 89-59, the final result on the free skate for Leslie Hawker. Add that to her short program, 136-55, and so Leslie Hawker, the 26-year-old from Alliston, Ontario, is currently in first place. Well, the final six are set to take the ice. Can Canada's Joanie Richet move up? We'll return to